On November 21st, Iuliia Kaplina broke the female speed world record during the qualification round of the European Championships, finishing her climb in 6.964 seconds in the right-hand lane. This makes her the second woman to break the 7-second barrier on an official wall after Indonesia's Eri Susanti Rahayu posted a 6.995 at the Xiamen World Cup just over a year ago. While Iuliia didn't win the gold medal in Moscow, her new record has put her name back in the spotlight after 2020 was void of any speed world cups and 2019 was marred by her leg injury in China that caused her to miss World Cup events for the first time since missing Mokpo in 2012. The same injury and absences also took her out of contention for a medal at the end of the 2019 season by only a couple of points. I consider Iuliia to be the greatest female speed climber of the modern era, and when I say modern era, I mean since around the start of 2013, when Speed World Cups were first held entirely on standard walls, as far as I can tell. Iuliia has, after all, held the speed record 4 times, according to the IFSC, or according to her Instagram bio, 10 times, or according to YouTube, some number of times in between. Unfortunately, the record-keeping around speed records has been shoddy, so to prove her greatness, I should look for other evidence. Let's compare her medal count to her only real contender, Annick Joubert of France. Annick is only 1 year younger than Iuliia and actually debuted on the World Cup scene 1 year before her in 2011. In total, Annick has competed in 59 Speed World Cups or championships, and Iuliia has competed in 52, so only 7 events fewer. In their career, neither have won a World Championship gold medal, although both have earned a silver and a bronze. Both athletes have been on the podium at the end of 6 straight World Cup seasons, although Annick edges Iuliia 2 golds to 1. And both are decorated at World Cup events, each winning 7 or 8 bronze medals, Iuliia beating Annick in silver medals 11-6, but Annick Joubert earning a whopping 15 gold medals to Iuliia's pitiful 12. So unfortunately for my argument, those numbers would empirically show that Annick Joubert actually has more gold in her trophy than Iuliia, if only by a few medals here and there. So if Iuliia holds a couple records, but Annick has the medals, what convinces me that Iuliia is the real winner? What puts her over the top as the greatest in my mind? Well, here's the stat I'm going to give you. In her 59 World Cups or championships, Annick Joubert has recorded the fastest time in any round, an impressive 7 times. That is 12% of her events that she records the fastest time of the entire field of competitors. She sets the standard at these events more often than anyone, except for Iuliia Kaplina. Annick Joubert is the fastest at 12% of her events. Iuliia Kaplina is fastest at 48%. At 25 of her 52 World Cups and World Championships, Iuliia Kaplina records the fastest time. Whether it's in qualifiers, semis, finals, she is by far, in fact by fourfold, the cutting edge of speed climbing. Over her career, pick any event, she may not win gold, but you have a 50-50 chance that she'll record the fastest time of anyone. No one else comes anywhere close. So now I explain why I dragged the IFSC into this clickbaity title, and the reason is that I can't give you a primary source for the statistic that I just presented. As I alluded to earlier, the record keeping on the IFSC's website is a bit of a mess, and here's how I know. By pure chance, in early 2019, just for the fun of it, I started transcribing the podium results from every IFSC World Cup and World Championship, as well as some other facts like the number of flashes at each event in bouldering or the fastest time at each event in speed. Unfortunately for the sport, at some point since I recorded those details, the IFSC has decided that complete results aren't knowledge that fans or commentators or journalists or presenters deserve to have, and they've entirely removed sections of scores from each event in their records. In speed climbing, you can't see a climber's time from each round anymore. In bouldering, you can't see a problem-by-problem breakdown anymore. In fact, you can't actually see which climbers were in which flight or group from qualifiers anymore. So while I can cite Yulia's incredible 48% record of being the fastest at events, I can't even double-check that number. Those who I asked to edit this video can't double-check it either. So maybe I'm lying right now, or more likely, maybe my records included typos or accidental duplicates. Neither of those would be impossible, given I've had to transcribe literally hundreds of events worth of results. While the IFSC website has always been frustrating to navigate through athletes or events or results, it is so much worse when information and functionality that was available before is being actively removed. And removed right as climbing approaches its biggest moment in the spotlight, the moment we've been waiting for decades, the Olympic Games. More and more people like me will be digging through the history, trying to learn more and uncover compelling stories around our Olympic athletes for you. So why would the IFSC ever take away the most important resources for us to build legends around these great climbers? I emailed the IFSC for comment. I spoke with their head of communications, Marco Vettoretti, whose department is responsible for the website, and he agreed that the website doesn't work well, and that the pages for results work less effectively than before. He says that his department is working with the IFSC sport department to have a much better results page for the start of the 2021 World Cup season, and that they hope to have an overall improved website before the start of the Olympic Games. He also confirmed that the records that have since gone missing from the site are still archived somewhere, so at least that data can be recovered eventually. I hope Marco and his team are successful, because I know firsthand that there are remarkable stories like Iuliia's 48% fastest rate waiting to be discovered among the years and years of score sheets and speed brackets, but we can only find those stories if we can rummage through all of the documents and results. So Iuliia Kaplina is the greatest female speed climber of the modern era. But for now, you cannot take my word for it. Thanks to the G5 for supporting this video. If you would like Plastic Weekly stickers or to get a shout out at the end of these videos, go to the Patreon link in the description below. And of course, if you want to watch the European Championships with me and some other like-minded friends, hop in the Discord, or if you want to mouth off and try and prove to me that Iuliia Kaplina is not a goddess among women, then you can debate it there with me too. Check out the Discord. I'll see you in the next one.